بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الطلبة الأعزاء، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، وأهلا ومرحبا بكم في هذا الجزء العاشر للمحور السادس من مادة Theory of Machines، والذي بعنوان Gears. I will present here force analysis and start by spool gearing. With a pair of gears or gear sets, power is transmitted by the way of forces developed between contracting teeth. This figure presents the force distribution on one tooth. Okay? Here we have the resultant force W, the radial force WR, and the tangent force WT. The total force, or the resultant force W, is situated or located on the pressure line. Okay, let's see here. We have phi is the pressure angle. WT, the tangent force, is equal to W cosine phi. WR, it is equal W sine phi. The velocity V, it is equal to the radius, or the half of the diameter, multiplied by the angular velocity. So it is equal to d pi into rpm divided by 60. We know that the power P in watt, it is equal to the force, tangent force, multiplied by the velocity. It is equal also to the torque into the angular velocity. V, it is called the pitched line velocity. The WT, tangent force, in kilonewton, it is equal to the power divide the velocity, or the pitch line velocity. The formula is the following. It is equal to 60,000 P in kilowatt, P in kilowatt, divided by pi into D in millimeters into angular velocity with RPM. Let's move now to the forces in helical gearing. So WR, the radial force, is equal to W sine phi n. This is W, and here we have the radial force, and here we have the angle phi n. Okay. WT, it is equal, tangent force, it is equal to the resultant force W into cosine phi n cosine c, and the axial force WA is equal to the resultant force W into cosine phi n into sine c. Then the WR, the radial force, is equal to tangent force multiply tangent phi. The axial force, it is equal to tangent force into tangent c. Then the resultant force, here we can find out the final form of the resultant force. It is equal to tangent force WT divided by cosine phi n cosine c.